Hey guys, I'm just going to do a quick manga slash anime tutorial on how to draw a couple of eyes, so I can show you how I've progressed through a couple of years. I've been doing this for about until I was in primary school, which was a couple of years, but I think I've slowly progressed. I'm not really quite sure, but see how it goes today. But we'll try some different eye types and see how it goes. So I'll try a style for the a male eye thing. Hopefully. Using a H pencil, so it'll be easy to rub off afterwards, in case you have any like mistakes. I find it useful, I only just figured that out. So you've got the basic bowl for the eye, as you can see. And just gonna start with the top brow. I'm just gonna slowly curve over. Like the width of the eye there. And then we'll come along the bottom of the eye there. It doesn't matter how exactly you do it because it will just come off quite easily. Use a HB pencil there, if you're wondering. Duh. Right, let's see. I'm going to go in for how the basic eye would be, so about there. There. Across. And then it's going to be a little bit shorter just to get the actual pupil in the eye. It doesn't have to be completely down. Across there, so that'll be our basic cat template. And we're just going to go inside. The highlights in the top, and one at the bottom. So I'm coming out a bit so you know where to rub off. God, I hate smudging. Come in there. Get the pencil again, go over a bit. So little like perks. Okay. We're with like male eyes a bit like bigger than, well, slightly width range is much more than the actual girl eyes. If you like check other people's videos, but hey ho, you're watching mine. And we're just gonna thicken top eyelashes to give that more dense. Hopefully look in the eye. So bring it out a bit more. And after that we are going to do the actual pupil itself. I've seen a lot by saying mostly mangas that have just the actual another ball inside of the eye. Instead of like people do this. And then they'll come along like that, but I like it this way. As you get to thicken just the pupil so it's darker than all the rest, so you can actually, so it stands out in the middle of the eye if you go over with shading. So you start the first layer up there, come down, just gonna come down like that. And if you want with this light pencil, you can over slightly for the rest of the eye. Don't worry if you go over the lines, you can rub them out. Pencil. Sorry if my voice sounds a bit awful because it's probably my second try of a video. Not very talkative, you know, how it goes. I'm just gonna thicken the eyeball so it stands out. Because a lot of, if you watch Fairy Tale, they'll have like some, if you look closely, they'll have like really thick edges around the eyes. Start with the dark shading, get it out. It starts to come off slightly. We get darker inside. Keep the exact same. Go down here. Start to get a little, if you want, little dashes in the eyes. Over with the little flap of the eyes. So it's come quite close. But some other little bits we had detail where you add another flick into the eyes there and there. So it stands out a bit more. And also some bit shading here. We can some if we're well. What I should have done was with the light pen, so if you go over very slow, like slightly over near the eye, give shadowing. And also around here. Because sometimes it may not look right without the without the shading, so it's a bit. Yeah. I'm just gonna darken the top bit up here. Follow it down here. Now we're just going to do the eyebrows now. So you see all the shading there. So it doesn't look empty. Let's go with a. Let's go with an angry look. Gonna cut across the brown there. Brown line. Just from here to there. So when you go over with the paint pencil, do a little shading. So it darkens, then you can go. Each pencil go round, show where the angry eye brow meets there. And we continue. And if you want, you can add a little bit of a little one there, show how our angry is. And under that, you do a little bit of shading. And you just thicken that line. Give it more anime effect, I guess you can call it, or manga. Well, people say manga, I don't really care. Something I love doing. And then we do the brows. inside of that. But with the gun you can use the rubber to get rid of all the unwanted stuff that you want. So like this bit, maybe I just give it more of that disappearing. Go out tents and stairs on this back. Well, that's one way of doing it. Try with a female by now. My voice is becoming a bit croaky. Alright. So that's the male eye. I'm not really sure if that's good or not, but some bits can be. Again, with the rubber, you can just do things. Like edging them out a bit so they look more professional, I guess. So and yeah, I would definitely use these two, H and HB, definitely. And well, you can use other ones, but that's if you want to get into serious detail. But yeah, moving on. Let's go with a female eye. Females more innocent, I guess. Small, but there we go. Oh, I have to keep reminding myself to use all that one. So we're going to come over with that. Top of the eye. Down. That'll be the under eye. Again, I'm not going to go straight into it. Like that one. Again, I'm doing a bit differently. We always do different techniques or different ways of doing drawings every time, but it works somehow, I guess. Back up again. Cuts off there. So now we've got the basic eye. start to curve upwards. Then I can add some little eyelashes. Starts to look a bit iffy around in eyelashes because you can just go with the rubber and start going down and flick upwards. I'll get rid of making a little pointy, I guess you can call it. And then do the shadowing there. Side of the eyes again, make it come all the way over, just like, so there's a little bit of gap there and there.